information. Sa turning circle. Then you have your tactical and you have your final. Yan yung training circle nyo. Yung institute natin noon, that is your turning radius. Pagka umangkla kayo. Diba? Now, yung track line. Yan yung track line nyo. Yan yung when you say track line, yan ang susundan ng pivot point nyo. Mr. Eusebio, pakimugong ay may aso ka. Okay? So, initially, sa, basta imagine natin, okay, we're heading north. Ganun na lang. So, advance. Distance travel in the direction of the original heading. So, yan yung mga nasa question niya, di ba? Measured from the point at which the helm was first applied. Yun yung advance. Original heading. When your heading was 00 or to north. Okay? Now, when you say transfer, the distance of the center of gravity of the ship from the original track line measured in 90 degrees to the original heading. So, may 90 degrees siya from the original heading. But sometimes, sa question nyo, wala yung number. Ano meron? Yung word na 90. So, pag kumambyo na kayo ng 90, that is the transfer. When you say tactical diameter, the transfer for a turn of 180 degrees, which is almost equal to your maximum or maximum diameter yan, yung pinakamalaki. And when you say final diameter, the diameter for a circle traversed by a vessel after turning through 360 and you are maintaining the same speed and run. Diba?
Yes.
Okay? Yun lang, may mga number siya sa question, may mga number. Hanapin niyo yung mga number na yan.
Oh. Okay, okay, sir. Wala ng kamay.
Sa isang picture lang yan, kuha na eh. Oh. Now, when you say drift angle, itong pula, sabi ko nga, yan yung track line nyo. Yan yung sinusundan ng pivot point nyo, hindi ng forenath line. Yung difference of your track line and your forenath line, that is the drift angle. Kaya nga sabi ko, kung napanood nyo naman yung Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift, tama ba? Paano umiikot yung sasakyan nila? Medyo bumabalagbag, di ba? Kaya nga drift eh. Magkakaroon ng drift. So, when you say drift angle, the angle between the tangent to the turning circle at any point and your forenath line. And your pivot point. Pivot point, the point above which the vessel pivots with your bow swinging inwards. Pumapasok at yung pupa nyo bumubuka. Now, sa pivot point, when you are going ahead, paabante kayo. Nasaan ang pivot point?
One-third
forward.
Iba-iba yung sagot. May one-third, may one-sixth, may one-fourth. From the bow. Tama ba? Okay. When you are stopped, pagka nakatigil ang barko, nasaan ang pivot point?
Midship.
About midship or yung isang sagot, center of gravity.
Yes, sir.
Tama ba? Now, ano ang 5.5 pagka umaatras yung barko?
Pagpunta sa pupa, sir.
One third after.
One third from after. Nasa after. If you are moving astern na. Ngayon, yung tanong, umaabante kayo, then, nagbawas kayo ng speed. Pag umaabante kayo, nasa na 5.5 ito. Diba? Once na nagbawas kayo ng speed, ano nangyayari sa 5.5?
Umaatras, sir.
Oh. Hindi ibig sabihin nandito sa atras. Umaatras siya, aatras siya. Hanggang pagtigil nyo, nandito na siya sa chip. Yun yung isang tanong about the 5.5. It is moving up. Umaatras yan. Para pag stop yung takbo nyo, amidship siya. Okay? Oo. Ano nangyari? Nag-up? Oo. From the point where the rudder is put over. Oo. At any point on the turning circle. The distance a vessel moves parallel to the original course is known as
advance.
On the turning path of a vessel, what do you call the distance of the ship's center of gravity along the original course from the commencement of rudder deflection to the point where the ship has turned 90 degrees?
Transfer.
Ayun yung 90.
Transfer.
Oh, so that is your
transfer.
What is the diameter of a circle called which traversed by vessel after running through 360 degrees?
Final diameter.
Final diameter, sir.
Oh, so that is your final diameter. Okay. Makikita nyo rin yung mga number dyan eh. Oh. Is the distance from a port approach towards to the ship's center of gravity when it has turned 180 degrees? Ngayon, sa bridge, meron kayong turning circle eh. Diba? Actually, one is on the loaded condition and the other is on the ballast condition. Isang ihot sa istribor at isang ihot sa pabor. Oh. Diba? Ang tanong, anong mas malaki? Yung ihot sa istribor o ihot sa pabor?
Depende sir kung right-handed propeller.
Okay. Yan ngayon ang isasagot nyo pag tinanong kayo. Depende, sir, kung is right-handed or left-handed propeller. Mr. Rementina, pakimute ang mic. Now, we stick to a right-handed. If your vessel is a right-handed propeller, ano mas malaki? Is it turning to port? Or turn to starboard?
Turning to port.
Which has a bigger diameter?
Turning to port, sir.
Turning to starboard, sir.
Right-handed.
Oh, right-handed ang pinag-uusapan natin. Tama ba? Anong tinatanong natin? Anong question? Which has a bigger or a larger diameter?
Starboard. Bigger diameter to starboard.
Oh.
Because right-handed.
We are talking of a right-handed vessel. Right-handed. Ano mas malaki, ang ikot o ikot sa istribor?
Yung ikot sa istribor.
Una, if it is a right-handed propeller, umaabante. Saan papaling ang proa?
Port side.
Port side. So which means, kung iikot sa pabor yan, since if your rudder is amidship, pumapaling na sa pabor. Kung dinagdaga mo pa yan, so this is, you have a bigger diameter here or a larger diameter sa stripper. Kasi kung iikot ka na stripper, kukontrahin mo pa yung lateral effect niya. Ako, nyo?
Yes, sir.
Samantalang dito, maaparte ka palang kumakabit na sa pabor dito sa right handed. Okay? Now, you are on course 00 degrees through and put the rudder right 30. In which direction will transfer be measured? Pagka may transfer, 90. Okay? Head reach. Ako, haba niya. Haba ng choices. In a stopping distance of vessel, can this be described as what?
Stationary.
So, ano nga hanapin yung word?
Stationary.
So, head reach is the distance the traveler has actually run between taking action to stop her and being stationary in the water. Yung inumpisahan yung patigilin hanggang tumigil siya. That is the head reach. Okay, sa MOB, in the maneuverboard situation, you have three scenario. One is the immediate action. When you say immediate action, the casualty is noticed on the bridge and action is initiated immediately. In short, kayo, guardia official, nakita niyong may nalaglag, then you took the action immediately. Kayo, guardia official. The second is a delayed action. In a delayed action, the casualty is reported to the bridge by an eyewitness and action is initiated with some delay. Okay? Ibig sabihin, may nangyari sa kubyerta, may nagtatrabaho sa kubyerta, nakita ni Maestro or whatever, at may nag-report sa bridge. There is an eyewitness. So may delay, saglit lang, mga minuto lang. Okay? And when you say person missing, the person is reported the bridge as missing. Ibig sabihin, oras na pagitan nito. Nung nag-almusal kayo, nandyan, nung mananghaliyan kayo, wala na. So missing person na. So mahaba na oras niyan. Okay? So una, immediate action, kayo guardia official. Number two, delayed action. May eyewitness, may nag-report sa bridge. So may minutong delay. Person missing, oras na pinag-usapan. Okay. Now, ang heading natin, 400. May nalaglag sa stribor. Then nag-hard starboard kayo. Okay? Then eventually, bumalik kayo sa original course nyo. Tama ba? Isang ikot. You call this the single turn or the Anderson turn. Yan yung Anderson. Isang ikot. Now, may limitation yan. Kaya nga sabi natin, in an immediate action, nakita nyo, the single turn will take the ship back to the scene of casualty most quickly. Yan yung pinakamadali. Pangalawa, pag nakita niyong nahulog siya sa stribor, papalikan niyo rin sa stribor. So, hindi siya nawawala sa paningin niyo. Habang nandito kayo sa stribor, ayan yan, tuloy-tuloy kayo. Nakikita niyo pa rin siya. Yun ang advantage ng Anderson turn or single turn. However, may limitation naman yan. The single turn method of returning the maneuverboard should be used only if the vessel is very maneuverable. kung yung barko ay kaya niyang patigilin. Kung hindi, huwag niyong gawin. Baka masagasaan niyo pa. Or most likely, malalagpasan niyo siya. Yun ang ibig sabihin niya. Kung kaya niyong mapatigil, well and good. Now, what maneuver will return your vessel in the shortest possible time to a person who has fallen overboard?
Anderson.
Okay, ayan na si Anderson.
Anderson.
Wow. Dito na naman tayo. Heading north. Sa istribor na laglag. Then yung mate, hard starboard. Nung mag 60 degrees, yung may the hard port. Tama ba? Then you go to your reciprocal course. Magwawanipa. So ito, nalaglag sa istribor, pupulutin mo sa pabor. Theoretically. Okay, theoretically. Okay? You call this the?
Yan
yung Wilson. Now, ito lang tandaan nyo. When you will be taking your practical assessment, meron kasing Williamson yan. Ito lang advice ko. Do not wait for 60. Kasi sabi nga, pag 60, mag-hardport ka. No. 40 pa lang ito, mag-hardport ka na. Diba, napag-usapan natin kahapon sa rudder angle nyo. From hard starboard to hard port, how many seconds?
20, sir.
O, 20 to 28 seconds yan. Diba? 20 to 28 seconds. Pag inantay nyo na 60 yan, aabot kayo ng 90 bago kumagat yung rudder nyo o susobra pa. Kasi habang tumatagal, yung rate of turn nyo tumataas. Kaya pag 40 pa lang yan, at ililipat nyo na from hard starboard to hard port, pag nag-60 yan, kumakagat na. Oh, yun ang una. Okay. Number two, do not reduce your RPM. Okay? Huwag nyong bawasan yung speed nyo. Why? Kasi, once na you do a hard starboard, magkakaroon ng drag, babagsak yung speed nyo. How much more, ilalagay mo siya sa hardport, babagsak ulit. Yung iba kasi, banda rito, nagbabawas na ng speed. Lalaki yan. Pagka inantay nyo yung 60, bababa yan ganun. Pag nagbawas kayo ng RPM, lalaki yung diameter nyo. Pagdating nyo rito, almost reciprocal, doon kayo magbawas ng speed. Matagal na kayo dyan. Okay? Yan lang advice ko kay Williamson. Kasi sa practical niyan, may oras din yan. Okay? Now, kay Williamson, in the immediate action, kayo barge official, kayo nakakita, the Williamson turn requires more time and will temporarily take the ship farther away from the scene of casualty. Kasi nga, what happens here? Iiwan nyo siya. Iiwan nyo. Ano pa isa? Nakikita nyo sa starboard, then eventually, lilipat kayo ng pabor. There is the possibility na mawala siya sa paningin nyo. Okay? Now, in a delayed action, the Williamson turn will take the ship to the scene of the casualty most surely. And in a person missing, the Williamson turn will take the ship back into her wake. Natin. Yan yung puti. Restricted visibility or at night. Pag kami night, you talk of the Williamson. Okay? Ayan yung mga question dyan. Now, morning and was last seen after coming of Edwards. Which type of turn would you use to return to the track line steam during the night?
Hanson.
You suspect that a crew member has fallen overboard during the night. immediately execute with reversal turn. What is the primary advantage of this maneuver under this circumstance? From north, magiging south yung kwan nyo. Babalik kayo south. Okay? Okay? Next. Yan siya. And eventually, you're heading north. Nalaglag sa estribor. Gaganong kayo. You call this the Sharno turn. So Sharno turn, actually ang Sharno turn, mahaba na yan, gadamang pa din, eventually pabalik ka. Okay? Kay Williamson, dito kay Williamson, ang kalaglag niya ng hard starboard gadam. Yan ang pagkakaroon na. Okay? So dito, nandito yung MOB mo, malayo. Kay Williamson, nandito. Okay, yan yung Sharno turn. Sa Sharno turn, in an immediate action, Sharno turn is not appropriate, hindi nyo gagamitin. Now, in the delayed action, the Sharno turn cannot be carried out effectively unless the time elapsed between the occurrence of the casualty and the commencement of maneuver is known. At alam nyo yung time difference. Now, in the person missing, Sharno turn will take the ship back into her wake, but less distance is over than Williamson turn, thus time safe. Nagkaroon sila ng pag-aaral between the Sharno turn and the Williamson turn, at sabi, mas mabilis si Sharno turn kaysa. Okay? Na nasa question din ng ibang banya. Okay. A crew member has not been seen on board for the past 3 hours.
Williamson.
What type of turn is best in the manner?
I don't know.
Oh, past 3 hours na.
No.
What is your? Sure, no. Missing na, oras na. Oras pinag-uusapan. You are in watch and see a man fall overboard. Which man overboard should not?
Sharno.
So that is your Sharno. Okay? Now, besides saving distance along the truck line, another advantage of the Sharno turn, advantage of the Sharno turn, over Williamson turn in a maneuverboard situation is because
it is faster.
Is faster, mas mabilis si Sharno kay Williamson. Okay? You are duty officer on the bridge. An eyewitness is reporting a man overboard. Which of the following actions is considered as a correct maneuver?
Williamson, eyewitness.
Baka may eyewitness, it is Williamson. O pagka past 3 hours, si Sharno. You are duty officer bridge. A person is reported missing. Which of the following actions are to be considered as the correct maneuver in this situation?
Sharno. Sharno.
Bakit Sharno?
It's more than enough. It's more missing.
While the vessel is underway, one of the crew reported the man overboard. Which of the following maneuver is appropriate?
Why?
Also not allowed. For example, reported. Mr. Kuya,
crew reported. Crew reported. One of the crew.
Ayun. One of the crew reported. Ibig sabihin, eyewitness. Williamson. Okay? Next. What is the key to the most rapid and effective response to man overboard situation?
Communication. Communication.
Okay? So, sabi natin, sa we have three scenario. Karami na mag-usapan dyan. Isa pa ito. Nalaglag sa estribor. Left. 0-0, nalaglag sa estribor. What happened? Umikot kayo. Titignan nyo. Para siyang single turn na nauna. Diba? Yung single turn, isang ganun lang yan eh. Ito, nauna. Actually, nandito yung nalaglag. Gumanong kayo, nag-steady kayo ng 180 rito. Then eventually, bumalik kayo ng 360. Kaya ito, nag-180 kayo rito. Then eventually, bumalik kayo ng 360. Ito, parang single turn lang na na-stretch yan eh. You call this the double turn, the elliptical turn, sorry. You call it the racetrack turn. Racetrack turn, double turn, or elliptical turn. Okay? Now, the racetrack turn in an FOB situation, the vessel is steadied for the second time after okay. Turn of 360. Yung first time yung nag-steady is what?
180.
Now, the racetrack turn is superior to a Williamson turn in an MOB situation when the seawater is very cold and the van is visible. Ang advantage ni racetrack turn, titignan sa drawing niyan, nasa estribor kayo, makikita niyo siya, hindi siya nawawala sa line of sight niyo. Okay? Hindi siya nawawala sa line of sight. Okay. A racetrack turn is used to recover a man overboard. The vessel is first steadied but how many degrees away from the original heading?
180.
First steadied, so that is 180. In a racetrack turn, to recover a man overboard, the vessel is steadied for the second time.
360.
360. Okay? Now, parang signal nyo, 3 long last, 3 prolong. Now, the datum or your last reported position, dyan kayo mag-uumpisa ng search point. Kung saan yung huli position niya, doon kayo mag-uumpisa. Now, kung merong drifting yan, susundan nyo. Diba? Kung anong direction ng drift, doon kayo. Okay? So, meron kayong isa rito. Okay. Then, susundan nyo siya. Then, eventually, that is the last reported position, pag ganun ang mangyibrada nyo. Kung papansin ninyo, nandito lang kayo sa area na yan. Okay? You call this the second surface. Sa area ang ito lang, hindi kayo lumalayo. Maliit lang yung area. Okay. Now, a man was sighted as he fell overboard. After completing a Williamson turn, the man is not sighted. Kasi pinalikan nyo, nawala. What type of search should be conducted?
Sector search.
That is the sector search. Following the loss of a man overboard, you take the cone and complete a Williamson turn maneuver. But are unable to locate the man in the water, what would you do now?
Alpha.
Yan. I will conduct a sector search as recommended by the EFSA. Okay. What is the search system pattern called using? Okay. Pag nakita niyo one vessel, that is the sector system. You should conduct a sector search under which of the following circumstances? Okay, so that would be the search target is sighted and lost. Nakita nyo at nawala. Kaya nga yung question na tabi yung Williamson turn kanina, pagbalik nyo, hindi nyo makita. So, you conduct a sector search. Now, ito naman isa. That is the datum, yung green. Then, eventually, puro 90 degrees ang kambyada nyo. So, what is happening? Lumalaki. Diba? Palaki siya ng palaki. At yun nga, kundrado. So, you call this the expanding square. Kung lumalaki siya. Okay. Expanding square. You're proceeding to the area of reported distress. When you arrive at the reported position, the vessel in distress is not sighted. What type of search should be conducted?
Sounding.
Expanding square. Now, a man was sighted as he fell overboard. After completing a Williamson turn, the man is not sighted. What type of search should be conducted?
Sector.
Sa sector, ang hinahanap nyo tao. Okay? Sa expanding square, ang hinahanap nyo...
Barko.
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 O lifeboat. Okay? O, kasi yung area niya lumalaki sa sector, nandun lang kayo sa area nyo. Okay? Yun ang tanda nyo, ah. O, pag tao, sector search, pag barko, expanding square. O. Next. Yun naman ngayon yung datum. That is the direction of the drift. Now, may dalawang barko. So eventually, sabay sila. Okay? Makita nyo, there is a parallel line. Okay, parallel line. Ang dalawang barko yan. They call this the parallel track search. Dalawang barko. Okay. Kaya nga, what is the search pattern system called using more than one ship?
Parallel system.
Kung one ship lang, that is the sector. More than one ship, parallel. You are proceeding to the area of a reported distress. When you arrive at the reported position, you find two other vessels. So, may nakita kang dalawa. Kasama ka, pangatlo ka na. But the vessel in distress is not sighted. What type of search? So, parallel track. Okay, so parallel, more than, no? More than one ship. What is the search pattern that may be used when the degree of detection may have an equal probability of being anywhere in the... Okay? Now, ito naman. Diretso ka lang. That is, of course, as directed by Onsen Commander. Then eventually, may aeroplano. Okay. Saan dumaan yung aeroplano?
Proa.
Sa proa nyo. Ano niya? Malaking difference yan. Dadaan sa proa o sa popa, may ibig sabihin. Okay? So, dumaan siya sa proa nyo. Ay, ikaw, diretso ka lang. Yun ang sabi sa'yo, you call that the coordinated creeping line surface. Tumaan siya sa proa nyo. Ano nakalagay doon? Ang proa, that is your course. Okay? Pag dumaan siya sa proa nyo, kailangan ka niya. Not unless, yung isang tanong, hindi ka makakarating, ay you raise the November flag. Hindi ko makakomply. Pag dumaan siya sa pupa nyo, pag sa pupa, ang nakalagay is your wake. Okay? Pag dumaan sa pupa nyo, alas ka na. Tapos na. Okay? So, yung matanda nyo. Pag